perhaps the most despised character on TV today.
Listen to me, you black lung son of a bitch. I'm gonna expose you and your project. Your time is over.
The X-Files' very own Darth Vader.
Don't try and threaten me, Mulder. I've watched presidents die.
But it wasn't always that way for the X-Files' cigarette-smoking man.
William B. Davis, who plays a cigarette-smoking man, thought he had lost out. He got the non-speaking role in that episode, and he's just a guy leaning on a file cabinet in that show. And most of the first season went by without him saying a word.
I remember that scene. What was that, 20 years ago?
They said, stand beside the filing cabinet while they were interviewing Scully in her kind of first interview in front of the FBI director. And I remember thinking, as I'm standing, you know, this guy's smoking in a place he shouldn't smoke. So I slouched over the filing cabinet. That kind of set a tone of relaxed authority, I suppose.
From a bit player to the puppet master, in the show's sixth season, it seems it's the cigarette-smoking man who pulls all the strings. Find out how, immediately following the feature, in an exclusive look at the cigarette-smoking man and the making of One Son.
Scan of the faces ending on CSM.
Basically, what we're trying to do is sum up or bring to conclusion all the many different facets of the mythology and bring it to one spectacular ending.
Quiet, guys, we got dialogue, radios are.
These are the types of episodes that strain every part of our operation. They have the most effects, they have the most characters. Every thread that we've woven over 5.5 years comes together in these 2 hours.
Nothing is ever too wrapped up around here, but there are a lot of efforts towards getting things wrapped up, at least.
X-Files cast and crew filmed the episode at top secret locations, including this World War II era blimp hangar just outside of Los Angeles.
Rehearsal, please.
In this extraordinary special effect scene, we finally meet the faceless alien rebels up close.
Behind us, we have what looks like a close encounters type of a look, and we have gears and motors, and we actually drive the spaceship up and down with it. Now, to hide all the rigging, we pump in thousands and thousands of gallons of fog oil. We have to bring everything we got in Hollywood, everything.
It's an extremely complex piece of work, even for those of us who work on it, you know, on a daily basis. We don't always get it. Is the cigarette smoking man really the good guy?
No.
Bill, I don't mind that camera.
Kim Manners, one of the feature's two directors, says working with the faceless aliens posed its own set of problems.
They were 7 hours in makeup, they were blind for 6 hours, and in some of the struggling scenes where they're getting their faces ripped off, if it didn't work take one, you were in real trouble, because it's another 7 hours to put that face back on.
Gunfire! In this conspiracy wrap-up, Mulder and Scully are once again met head-on by a barrage of unforeseen obstacles. In this flashback scene, we meet the cigarette-smoking man decked out in his 70 super threads as he and syndicate members await the arrival of the alien Greys. According to co-director Rob Bowman, little girls make the best aliens.
That if you're blocked behind somebody, then the camera can't see you, and then when you watch the show, we won't know it's you. Well, not that we'll know it's you anyway, but, well, you know what I mean. And action!
Jeffrey.
The Spender Adventurer. I received a phone call from Chris at home, and he said, I have some news for you in episode 12. And I said, what is it? Are you going to fire me? And he said, no, but I am going to kill you. He said, but trust me, it's an X-Files death. And I said, well, Chris, I trust you implicitly. And he said, well, trust no one.
I think each of the characters wishes that their character was the one who was making all the big decisions. You know, you've got Diana Fally, Mimi Rogers saying, you know, hey, geez, am I a bad guy? And, you know, how far do I go? And
I seem to have some association with the cigarette-smoking man, which came as a surprise to me, let me tell you.
You've never betrayed me. Now I need someone to trust.
This has been the most amazing journey. One Son takes the character a whole nother dimension.
Roll, please. Roll it.
I won't defend myself, except to say that the reason we're here now is because of what I've done. There are people who think that the cigarette smoking man is a bad guy.
that he's like the villain. I mean, you can look at these things all different ways.
Feeling smug, CGB?
There are moral questions that, you know, what would one do if one knew one was facing the apocalypse? What would you do? Save some people or just fight and all die in vain? I mean, there is a case to be made for what he's doing.
Let colonization begin.
While one son undoubtedly answers viewers' long-sought questions, in true X-Files fashion, you can bet there will be more twists and turns to come. Cigarette-smoking man wouldn't have it any other way.
It's the X-Files, right? It only adds new questions and, like, what's going to happen now? But it does kind of bring it to a, you know, I suppose if it was a symphony, maybe it's the end of the third movement.